Hello friends, welcome to Tech Learning YouTube channel. In this video, we will discuss about the technical specifications of magnetic flow meter, which you should know before purchase or installation of a magnetic flow meter. So let's get started. In this video, we will know about the following specifications of magnetic flow meter: transmitter type, line size, power supply, communication interface, flange standard and flange material, sensor lining, grounding rings, coil housing, electrode material, measuring tube material, and protection class. The first specs you need to mention is transmitter type. The magnetic flow meter has two parts. One is flow tube or flow sensor and second is transmitter. Select the transmitter type suitable for you. There are three types of transmitter available: remote type, integral type, and integral without display. Second is line size. The electromagnetic flow meter comes in the variety of sizes. You need to select correct size of flow tube as per your pipeline size where the flow meter is to be installed. The flow tubes is available in the various sizes starting from DN15 to DN3000. Third is power supply. The electromagnetic flow meters are available with the various input power supply options like 12 to 60 volts DC, 80 to 300 volts AC, inbuilt battery powered, and solar powered. Communication interface. Other than 4 to 20 mA output, the various communication interfaces are available in the flow meter. Please check if you need any special communication interface. The available communication interface are RS485, HART, Profibus, Foundation Field Bus, and UART. Flange standard and flange material. The flanges of flow tube of a magnetic flow meter are available in various design standard and material. The available flange standards are ANSI 150, ANSI B16.5, and PN standard. The flange material also must be selected carefully. The available flange materials are carbon steel, SS304, SS316, SS316L, and HDPE. Sensor lining. The magnetic flow meter can measure many corrosive liquids and abrasive slurries. The magnetic flow meter liners and electrodes can be constructed of the material that do not contaminate with the liquid. Therefore, the suitable lining material should be selected. The available sensor lining materials are hard rubber, PTFE, EPDM, and neoprene. Seventh is grounding rings. The grounding rings are used to suppress the electrical interference at the installation location of electromagnetic flow meter. They are provided in the pairs and installed in upstream and downstream of flow meter. The grounding rings are available in following material: SS316, SS316L, Hastelloy, and titanium. Eighth is coil housing. Two field coils are positioned inside the magnetic flow meter using rods, and they generate the magnetic field across the flow tube. The coil housings are available in carbon steel, SS304, SS316, SS316L, and SDPE. Ninth is electrodes. The electrodes are installed in the sides of flow tube at the right angle to pick up the electrical voltage. Select the suitable sensor electrode material. Electrodes are available in SS316, SS316L, Hastelloy C, and titanium. Tenth is measuring tube material. The measuring tube is available in following materials: SS304, SS316, SS316L, and SDPE. 11th is protection class. select the suitable protection class of your flow meter. The available protection classes are IP65, IP67 and IP68. Cable length. Select the suitable length of cable to be provided between the flow sensor and transmitter in case you are using remote type transmitter. The available cable length are from 10 meters to 80 meters.